Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button, like this video and share it to your friends and your family. Don't forget to also click on the notification bell, the bell beside the subscribe button, so that you are easily notified whenever I upload a video. If you're new here, thank you for tuning in and you're welcome to join the family. My name is Upsy. So in this video, I'll be showing you guys a makeup look, right? I've gotten so many requests on like makeup tutorials here and there, and I'm just like, okay, fine. I thought there were so many tutorials already online, but then if people are requesting, I might as well, you know. Yeah, and I'll also be showing you guys some affordable products. Some, I won't say drugstore affordable products that I have here. So everything I'll be using, from my eyebrows to my lips, are all affordable, and you can get them online or in store. So if you would like to see the finished look, please keep on watching. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to start with is my brows. And for my brows, to be quite honest, I don't really have an affordable eyebrow pencil that I like. My go-to like eyebrow pencil that I usually use on a daily basis, it's usually MAC or Fenty Beauty, but like for the purpose of this video, I have the Trend It Up water drop brow liner. Is waterproof, and I got this from DM. So, and I got this in the shade 040. That's the shade that's written here, and I'm not sure you guys can see it, but yeah, it's a Trend It Up brow liner. And because it's a bit dark, I'm just going to be using it lightly, like just light strokes, just because I feel like it's really dark for my skin tone. But if you're darker than me, I think this would really work for you. For my concealer, I'll be using the NYX Conceal Correct and Contour Palette, and it just looks like this. You can get it in Douglas, you can get it from the NYX store in Budapest as well, and I think you can also get it online if you check for it. So yeah, I'm just going to be using this shade right here just to like out to clean up any mistakes and just outline my brows. Okay, like I said, they're not usually like my go-to brow pencil because it's a bit dark, even though I like the fact that it glides on really smoothly. So that's why I really like this Trend It Up brow pencil. For the brow gel, I use usually my Rimmel London Brow This Way brow styling gel with argan oil, just as my brow gel, just to keep it in place so that there are no flyaways and it lasts long. Okay, so my brows are done. The next thing I'm going to do right now are my eyes. And the palette I'm going to be using for this is quite affordable, but then I know that we have a problem with like, what they call it, customs, because it's the Perception palette from ColourPop, and ColourPop is very, very affordable, extremely affordable. But the only problem I have with ColourPop is because it's in the US, so usually when the product gets here, you have to pay a customs fee or duties fee or tax, whatever it is. And it took me a long while to actually get this palette. If you can get your hands on this, then yeah, I recommend this palette because it's really, 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 really good. It has literally all the colors that works for the dark skin tone or whatever it is. And I think it also works for the lighter skin tones as well. You have the neutral colors, and then you can also explore with some blues and some purples and some greens. So yeah, this is really affordable. I don't really remember the price of this thing, but like, just check it out. So for this look, I'll be using the Culture first of all as my transition shade, just on my crease, just a little bit above my crease as my transition shade. Yeah, the next color I'm going to use on my crease is going to be, I'm torn between Revenge, this color here, and this color, but I think I'm just going to mix the both of them as my crease cut transition, just to build it up so that it's like a gradient, you know, if you understand what I'm trying to say. Yeah, but yeah, I'm just going to use these two colors next. Just picture so that it can show on my eyelid just a bit. With the same brush, actually, if I didn't see. But I find that this brush is a bit too big for the place, for the area I want to apply this product. So I think I'm going to go in with a smaller brush. And all my brushes, most if not all my brushes, are from Deluxe Hues. If you want to buy some of these brush sets, please contact Deluxe Hues on Instagram, or contact me on Instagram, or just leave a comment in the comment section and I'll hook you up with brush sets. It can serve as a very good gift guide for this Christmas period. So yeah, I'm going to mix the TF and the Diva shade to apply it on my lid. And this palette is really, really pigmented, and that's why I really like it. So it's just your classic bronzy, like brown eyeshadow look so far. There's nothing so spectacular. I'm just going to see if I can use this just a tiny bit. Let's just see how it looks on the eyelid. Just this. I'm so tired because it's really popping. And let's see. We'll make it work. We're gonna make it work. Work. Okay, so I'm just putting it like towards the outer corner of my eyes. And I will just easily blend it so that there are no harsh lines between the purple and the gold. And I'm using this Revenge to blend out any harsh lines. And then I use the same brush for the other part just to close up the gold and the purple. I'm going to go in with this, what's it called, shade. I don't know if you guys can see. Shade and play it out. I'm just going to mix with the shade. The difference between this is a bit like darker than this, and it has like a bit of shimmer in it as well. That's why I really like this one. And this is just your plain brown color. So I'm just going to mix both of them, and they are both really pigmented. Just take a look. So I'm just going to put it at the outer corner only and just blend it out and just brush it in. We're concentrating more on the outer corners just to give that smoky eye look. Always blend. Blending is key, guys. Blending is key. And then you... Yeah, this is what I've achieved so far. Trial and error, just playing around the palette, and that's literally how I come up with my look. So I really usually don't have a specific look I'm going for. Sometimes I do, like if I want a simple eye look or something, but sometimes I'm just like, let's just wing it, let's just have fun with it. So that's literally what I did. The eyeliner I'm going to use here, this is the Eye Studio Lasting Drama Gel Liner from Maybelline, New York. So it's a gel liner. I think that's what, because I like liners that are really dark and that last long time. So yeah, I'm just going to take an angled brush from Deluxe Hues and just going to dip it in the pan, just like so. Gel liners are good and they last long, like a long time. So, and I'm just going to like line my... This is what I achieved with the gel liner. So yeah, if you guys are looking for like affordable eyeliners, check out the Maybelline Eye Studio Lasting Drama Gel Eyeliner. It's really good. Now the next thing I'm also going to apply is my mascara, which is also from Maybelline. You can already tell that like it's one of my favorite brands that has like good products that are really affordable. So I'm using the Colossal Big Shot Volume Mascara. It just looks like this, the gold one, and I'm just going to coat my lashes with it. If you have lashes, this is the best time to apply your lashes. And the lash glue I use is the Duo Lash Glue. You can get the Duo Lash Glue from NYX shop. They have it and they have the one in black. I'm gonna apply my primer, and the primer I'm going to use is also from NYX and from H&M. If you have oily skin like I do, you would like these primers because this literally is your plug for drugstore oily skin. Yeah, so I'm just going to apply these two primers. I don't really get oily everywhere, just on my T-zone areas. So I'm just going to apply this on my T-zone and this everywhere else. Angelville primer, skin perfecting primer, Angelville. And the H&M primer is the mattifying face primer. So they have the other ones as well. So get the mattifying face primer, the anti-shine one. That's the one I use. Guys, so I went back in to like darken the outer corners because of the lashes, just so that you don't lose the eyeshadow in place. And also I reapplied the purple and the gold just as usual, just to intensify the colors and make them pop more. So now, because my primer is already dried, I'm going to apply my foundation. And for my foundation, I'm using the NYX Can't Stop Won't Stop in Sienna, and I'm also going to mix it with the NYX Total Control foundation in Cappuccino. This is a bit olive on me, so that's why I'm mixing both of them, but if you can find your exact shade, then that's fine. And these are also matte foundations, even though in this cold weather I don't really recommend using matte foundations, just because the weather is already dry as it is, so like using all of this is just going to make it even drier. So what I can recommend is, if you're going to be using matte foundations, you can try using like normal primers. Instead of using like matte primers, you can use like dewy primers. And also when you're finishing, you finish up with like the finishing spray that doesn't leave your face matte, just so that you can have a bit of dewy look because the weather is already cold and dry and everything. So yeah, I'm just going to be using this one is full coverage, and this is for the oily and combination skin, and this is in the shade Cappuccino, 410 Cappuccino. And funny enough, Cappuccino, but they are different shades. See, add this here, you can see that it's a bit dark for my skin as well, so I'm literally going to just mix both Cappuccinos. And I think this is a full coverage foundation, so yeah. But the Can't Stop Won't Stop is really, really, really matte, so I guess that's why it's dried, because I don't understand why. I've really not used so much of it because it makes me look green in a way. So yeah, I'm just going to go in with my concealer, and the concealer I'm going to be using today is the Makeup Revolution London. And I got this because they have the stand in Budapest, but they don't have our shade. So I got this one from Pink Panda, I think. So you can check Pink Panda website as well. They usually have some things for darker skin tone. So that's where I got this. So that's the concealer I'm going to use today for my under eye. Did I tell you guys the shade? This is C13. I also have the C12, but I find that it's really, really light for my skin. So that's why I'm using the C13. And guys, trust me, this concealer is amazing. It's literally just $6, I think. Or $8, one of them. It's not even up to $10. It's so good. It's really good. After I've done the concealer, I'm going to use my setting powder. And for the setting powder, where is it? I'm going, it's also by the Makeup Revolution Luxury Powder in Banana. So I really, really love this powder, guys. I really, really love it. So that's what I'm going to use to set my concealer. Set my under eye, rather. I don't really have a, should I say, a powder that can, a drugstore powder that can cover my full face. But usually I can use this contour set by NYX. It's a highlight and contour palette. But I'm just going to use like a shade that can cover like this to set. I feel like my face looks a bit red. That's my problem with drugstore. Like, I don't know, there's always something a bit off, but it's not so bad. Like, for the price, I mean, it's not that bad. So I also have this matte bronzer from NYX as well. I'm just going to use that. I have the ColourPop X Shayla highlight in Booming. It's literally a gold, like a gold dust. It's really, really nice. I really love this. And I also have this highlight from Douglas. Literally, it's not really as pigmented anyways, but you can, it's affordable, so you can try out these two products. Douglas highlighters is within reach. For ColourPop, is literally you have to order it online and it takes a while and everything. I'm going to take like the cap because it already has like some deposits in it, so I'm just going to take that and highlight. Can you see? Oh, please, I'm not trying to be a light bulb, but yeah, you see how pigmented this is, like really just a little goes a long way. That's the ColourPop Shayla, and it's really inexpensive, so yeah, you can shine like a diamond without breaking the bank. So I'm going to be mixing this and this for this. Let's see how it looks. So I'll start with this first. Let's see how pigmented it is. I just hope, let me use another brush. I'm using this one. I just hope it's not okay. Let's see. Okay, you see, it still does the job. Let's try this one. They even look alike, like, so I'm literally, it's not bad for, I think, I don't remember the price of this. Yeah, but my only problem is that it's still, on the skin is nice, like, it's not bad, but it's not, it doesn't soak into your skin and, like, make it look skin-like. That's the only problem, but for 4,000 francs, come on, like, you can't even go wrong. But yeah, I really, really, it's not bad, like, let's see. Apply this on my brow bone. On this side, I have the ColourPop, and on this side, I have Douglas one. So I'm just gonna apply that one. Ooh, you see? A pencil brush just like this from Deluxe Hues. I'm gonna apply this to my inner tear duct. This gold one. And I'm putting it in my. It doesn't work as much. It's really going to keep applying and applying. I'm just gonna use this Deluxe Hues brush and I'm just going to dip it in this. Just like this, tap out the excess, smile. And blend it in. If you feel it's too much, just take your powder brush and knit it a bit. Just going to take my Morphe setting spray. Actually, I think you can get a setting spray from NYX. I think they also have, I'm not really sure. Yeah, they do have, yeah. They have a setting spray. So they have the one for matte and then they have the one for dewy setting spray. So NYX has some affordable setting spray. You can also check L'Oreal and Maybelline. These other brands also have setting sprays in Douglas, in DM. But I got this Morphe one because I really wanted to try it, and it's not expensive as well. It's affordable, but you just need to order it online. That's the only difference. So yeah, and I like the sprayer very much. So literally drench my skin in this, and the next thing I'm going to do while my face dries is to do my lips. NYX retractable eyeliner. Actually, they also have lip liner, so if you're looking for a brown lip liner, check the NYX brown lip liner. They have a very good brown lip liner, but I'm just going to be using this eyeliner because I know it's not hygienic, guys, but don't judge me, because it's a bit darker for me than the average, like the normal brown one. So I'm going to mix the NYX lip pencil in brown. Actually, it's eye pencil, as I said earlier. Lightly, because it's really dark. And then I'm also going to take the lip liner, sorry, the lip Maybelline lip liner in Choco Pop. Let's see how. The NYX in London. I'll just go for a nude lip. You can use the London, or I think the Abu Dhabi is peach, is more like, can go with more of the eyes. So yeah, yeah. For my lip gloss, guys, I use the Kiko Milano lip gloss, the transparent part, and obviously it's transparent, but because of constant usage, that's why we have this. I really really like this thing. It's very inexpensive, but unfortunately there is no Kiko shop here. I think I got this when I went to Milan. So but with, I think you can obviously find any. Trendy Up also has like affordable lip glosses as well. The transparent one is amazing, amazing. And also check out like check out NYX. They also have really really good lip glosses, so you can check them out and use. I like the Praline, the Madeline, or what's it called. Those two are my favorite from the NYX house. But for this particular video, I'm going to be using the Kiko one. It's a top coat, so literally it's just gloss. Once again, I'm gonna drench my skin, just so that I don't look so white. And guys, this is the final look. Actually, no. We haven't done the lower lash line. How can we even forget? So, the same eyeliner. It's not hygienic, guys. Do not judge me. But it does the job. I'm going to line my lower lash line. I don't want it to be black, that's why I'm using the brown one. I'm going to go back into my palette and use this one, mixing it with this brown one, just to smoke out the lash line. Come to the final end of this video, guys. Everything I use here, guys, are affordable. If you have any questions and if you'd like to see more of these kind of videos, please don't forget to hit the like button. I'm really feeling this look, like I'm really 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 feeling this look. I hope you guys are also feeling it. So please 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 don't forget to subscribe and follow me on Instagram. If you want links to where I got this product, I'll leave some links in the description box below. And I will see you in my next one. Thank you guys for watching. See you.